Do an intro.
By Elden Ring, we're green. Because there's something about like dual-wielding weapons and like power stancing that's really cool to me. It's probably Kingdom Hearts' fault.
Probably, but I think it's just a pretty general cool thing.
Yeah.
Dual lightsabers, like...
Did you watch Star Wars as a kid?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought it was great. That's always the question.
I was never super into it, but we had the original trilogy and I watched them as a kid.
When do you show your kids Star Wars? Because it's not a terribly complex, like, show, but, like, when do you show it to them so that they can comprehend, like, the ideas of it and, like, also get the plot and think it's cool? Because if it's too young, they'll be like, it's just going to be baby brain and they're not going to, you know, comprehend what's going on.
9 or 10.
I think so, too. But I watched it when I was, like, 6.
Shows them again at age 22.
Yeah. Because when we were kids, it was the new trilogy was coming out. The second trilogy.
The prequels came out when we were in, like, very early elementary.
Yeah. I remember my brothers going to see it.
Oh, the dragon despawned.
That's because I rested.
Oh, cool. All right, cool. I got the key for free. He's back, and he's angry.
Yeah, I just got up. I just got up.
What have you done to me?
Hey, father. Hey, son. No bomb struck. The injured Batman awakens in a strange land and receive a quest. Become the lords of the land with their goblin strength and true green greed. There is no challenge this duo cannot overcome.
Did you see that clip of someone being like, man, I didn't know, it was either, I either bought the wrong Hogwarts game or I didn't know this game would be so hard. It's the Academy up here and the guy's getting fucking railed with glintstones.
No.
It's pretty funny. It's like when you're first coming into the steps and like there's the two guys at the top and they just keep fucking hitting you.
I was really sad with that Harry Potter game. One, because it's like, I don't know. There's a lot of controversy around it, and it's like, I'm sure people were excited. But also, I understand where the people that are angry are coming from.
I think it's pretty silly.
Yeah, well, my bottom line is, like, you're not really adding any more money into a billionaire's pocket.
No.
Ever.
It's a license. Anyways, yeah. Like, it's not like it matters. She has no part in the game.
I don't know. I fully understand that people don't like J.K. Rowling. She's a dumb lady.
She's stupid.
Lady.
But
she's a real silly person.
She made some cool fucking books.
I don't care for the books, but the movies have good music.
Sure. That's I never read the books either, but like she made a cool universe.
Sure.
I mean, it's the same thing as were saying before, separate.
She donates a lot to the artist from charity, the art, and that's awesome.
I didn't get the keys,
that's
cool. So
that's I did.
Yeah, so we'll have to teleport to that Grace site.
Oh, the thing I was saying about the Harry Potter game. Also, I'm sad because the combat in it is apparently really slow and is stinky. And that
It looked really cool when it was first coming out, but I don't know how it actually is.
The concept is surely interesting.
But it's a story game. Like, it's not like it's got PvP or anything. So, like, as long as it's fun.
I heard the combat was boring. And I was like, yeah. That's a shame. But also, if you just like Harry Potter and you're like a...
It looks good.
Like, console casual person that play video game. That's great.
Yeah. I mean, it looks really good. And, like, I mean, it looks like a fun game to explore, you know?
It doesn't have the problem every Japanese game does of not being able to actually make a black person and a character creator.
That's true.
Other than Neo. Neo Team Ninja really brought it out for everyone.
Really?
Other than that game, yeah. Like, none of the FromSoft games, they don't have any actual black hairstyles.
That's funny.
And Monster Hunter has them all locked behind DLC.
That's funny. Oh. We fused.
What's our fusion?
Endless.
Skin bin?
Skin bin's gross. But yeah, it's the controversy behind it is just silly to me.
I don't know. I understand.
There's a smithing stone back here.
I think boycotting something in a digital age will never work.
Yeah. Well, but, it's still, like I said, like, she barely is, like, she doesn't have any control over it.
Yeah.
And, like, it's, what are we supposed to just never watch the movies again or enjoy the piece of work that it is because of that? It's silly. It's the same thing as separating any artist from their work. If you want to do that, I mean, we could talk about, like, ancient Greek philosophers and, like, yeah, they had some great fucking writings and great lessons and stuff to read from, but most of them fucking touched kids.
All members, I was going to say, they were all members of Mambla.
Yeah. They all did it. They all touched kids.
Have you heard the thing about ancient Greece and being gay?
Yeah, they all were.
Well, no, like, it was like, you were cool to be gay, especially when you were kids, and you could have sex, and you could receive sex. But once you were an adult, you could only have, like, if you took it, they thought you were, like, a weird bitch and being childish. And that's a strange concept to me. Who's your favorite X-Men? This You've is always this. The greatest debate.
You've what? Asked me this.
In the last one?
Yeah.
Wait, really? I just really like X-Men, I guess. I'm sorry.
That's just funny.
I feel like it's the best way to gauge a person. If you ask them what their favorite anything else is, I don't think there's enough variety of, like, people and personalities, but X-Men's a really good one for that.
Yeah, well, the characters are actually characters, not just a big super guy.
Yeah.
They're more human.
It's not like Captain America, where the message is like, Nazis are bad.
Yeah.
Be good.
A piece of propaganda.
Yeah.
And a comic
X-Men,
book.
The point of the X-Men was they were, like, fighting what is essentially a civil rights battle.
Yeah. When they came out in, like, the 60s. Same thing
people
with, like,
really...
Star Trek did the same thing, where they were like, hey, this is a human problem. Let's just make it an alien problem. And then people would be like, oh, wow, that makes sense. They're just...
TNG was really good for them.
Yeah.
I mean, that's sort of what science fiction is all about at its core, is, like, commenting on some issue.
Yeah, social commentary, just with different stuff going on. It makes
what happens
it.
If we go there?
Nothing. You just come up around.
Okay.
It just makes it. It's a suspension of disbelief. Yeah. You can remove it from reality so much that, like, you don't recognize it as being the same as your reality when the issues are still the same.
Yeah. I always thought it was funny that people got really mad that Iceman was gay. And it was like, if there is any comic book scenario where you're doing this, this is the one.
Yeah.
Quintessentially, it's sort of proof that your problem is not with, like, the context. It's just that you don't want your Superman to be the gay.
Oh, this spot. There's that guy up here.
It does There's also the guy below that can teleport you to Volcano Manor.
Yeah, but I don't really want to do that.
If I can poise break him, we can probably kill him.
You mean if I can poise break him?
Yeah, that works too.
There you go. There you go.
Give me my bleed stack.
Nope.
No, it popped it, I think. Maybe not.
I don't think so. Bully him. Oh, gravity well. Not that we can use it. Oh wait, I can level up. Here we go, more health.
Here we go, can't get more health.
Do you want to run past all this?
Do you not want to fight the dog?
The dog?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know what dog you're talking about.
This dog.
I'm talking when we get around this corner here. So this is what I was talking about right here.
Oh, you just run. Just follow
me. That's what I was asking. You just wanted to run past it.
Oh, yeah, book it. That's pointless to fight that.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything good in that chest. You know there's a secret over here though, right? But now here's the deal. There's another secret. If we go up this ladder.
Somehow I feel like I've done this to you.
You have. So now you're up here, right? And then you jump down here. Now there's a bunch of pots down here, so be careful. Or be ready for that. It's this other way. Do not open that door yet. You know what? I didn't even think about a great example of separating an artist from their art and like the franchise and stuff they've created. Walt Disney, dude.
Yeah, or Dr. Seuss.
Yeah, Dr. Seuss was a little weird too, huh?
He was a really big anti-Semite. Did we talk about this last time?
I don't think so.
Okay, have you ever heard the thing about Dr. Seuss's wife?
I vaguely know what you're talking about.
So his wife got terminally ill. He left her because he didn't want to be with a terminally ill
Run.
Woman. Which way?
You'll know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. I do know.
Oh, shit. He can't come through the door, so he can't get out.
Maybe we can just poke him. Yeah,
I can poke him. Ow. I just gotta watch for the spells. Watch for the spells.
That was not a spell, that was a man.
Nah, the glintstone hit you, I think. Ow. Okay, they're aggroed on me still. Now it's going straight into the wall. Sweet. Okay, you got him.
Well, I got him. But this is a problem.
No, it's fine.
You're gonna have to, like, Mr. President me out.
Yep. Jesus!
Thanks, Mr. President.
Big stamina bar, thank God. Are you ready for this fox?
It's a dog.
That's a fox.
No, it's the great wolf.
No. Is it?
Yes. Yeah, it is. That's why I asked about the wolf earlier. And you're like, what are you talking about? There's no dog.
That's what I didn't know. I thought it was a fox, dude.
Cool.
Are you sure?
Read it.
Red fox, dude. Oh, he killed me. Nope, he killed you. You're dead.
That's a full spin.
Oh yeah. Put you through the fucking spin cycle, huh? Treated you like a goddamn dishwasher, huh? I might as well just submit.
Sorry, a kid was crying outside of my apartment because she lost her mom.
You tell her to shut up!
No, her mom opened the door and she was like, "You just needed to come up the stairs, baby."
How old was the kid?
Like, 3, maybe.
Okay.
She was carrying, like, a blanket. She was like, "I just want to sleep."
So I think separating the artist from their work only works if they're good.
No, it only works if their art doesn't have to do with the thing they did.
That's true too, I guess. But I think it's both.
Is a weird guy, and also he was in a movie about being a weird guy with a high schooler.
Yeah, that is weird, huh?
And he wrote a book about it.
Yeah, that is the really weird thing.
You can't separate the art from the artist at that point, because the art is the artist's mistake.
Yeah, but play some pretty good roles.
Sure. Doesn't make him any less of a weird...
Didn't say that. My Exhibit A was going to be Chris D'Elia. He's not funny. And a really scummy human being.
So I got a steak. Hey, dude. Hey, dude. Shut up. Hey. Shut up, dude. No. Don't. Hey, man. Hey. Nobody cares, dude. Don't. When you say that, I say, shut up, dude. I'm gonna. When you say that, I say, hey, dude. Hey. Nobody cares.
Were they children?
They were teenagers. Well, the thing is, there's no accusations of him actually doing anything as far as I know. Which I'm not. Yeah, but like, he never engaged in any activities as far as I know.
Activity, but I see what you're saying.
Yes, I do too. But supposedly he had stopped, and then he clearly did not stop. But people still like him for some reason, but I never thought he was funny to begin with. And he's still just doing the same shit, so.
Texting high schoolers or comedy?
Both.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Still texting high schoolers, that guy is?
Yeah, sure is.
That's a problem. Wasn't he married?
I don't know.
Or am I thinking of a different guy that did that? It's a problem when you can't remember because there are so many.
Yeah. I think some of them were pretty cut and dried too. Like he is just fucking weird.
Yeah, if you get convicted as a pedophile, it's pretty cut and dry.
Well, he's not exactly convicted, as you would say, but yeah, he's just fucking weird.
No, I just mean, like, most of the situations like this are, like, alleged until they're either arrested or there's proof.
Yeah. It's definitely not alleged with him.
No, he admitted it, didn't he?
Yeah, he did the first time. But then, like, he kind of had, like, a comeback for a year or two. And then, like, I guess recently
Man,
he got
cannot believe this guy.
Outed again. He keeps fucking jumping away, so I can't poise break him.
That sucks. I dodged the first one, and then the other two managed to hit me somehow.
No! You know what I'm really not looking forward to? Going back and beating Godric.
I want an actual strength-based weapon. The bleed weapon's really good for, what's her face? I don't know, the Rennala?
Yeah.
The bleed is very good for her.
Well, hopefully, because when I fought her, I killed her. It was pretty easy. I killed her pretty handily.
It's not a hard fight.
The hardest part will just be the spells. Yeah, the summon phase, hopefully I can just tank all the spells and take all the summons.
Yeah,
and
probably.
Then you can just whack her.
The hardest spells to, like, dodge in this game are, like, the fast burst. Like,
yes.
To get off me's.
Yeah.
And I don't think she has one of those.
The tracking ones are all pretty fucking annoying.
Tracking ones stink, but also they follow what is essentially a predetermined path once they target you. It's not horrendous.
They're like, we give me your boy.
There's a talisman that boosts your damage when you're at... Okay.
Well...
If I get hit by one of those, I just die.
Yeah.
And then they were doing Clover games. Jesus Christ.
What the hell, Benjamin?
Just be perfect.
Yes. Someone beat all the Dark Souls games. All the FromSoft games. Without getting hit once.
I'm not that guy.
Well, I need you to be. Oh, yeah.
It's either going to make me really good at Souls games, or it's just going to stink.
It's going to break you.
It's like playing Dark Souls at Soul Level 1, except everything in this game moves 30 times faster.
Yeah. Okay, it's all up to you, bud. You suck.
I'm sick, dude.
It's all up to you, jumps into the wolf's mouth.
Yeah, well, I did damage.
Sure.
I just died. He also did damage. That was the problem.
Much more.
I'm sure if he died in one hit, it would be hard for him also.
Well, it'd be easy for us, though, huh? That's kind of the whole point of this, to get you so strong that, like, you one-punch man everyone.
I know a build for that. It'll just take time.
Yeah. That's the challenge. Until we get, like, halfway through the game, it's going to be a struggle.
We can go get, what's it called? A larval tier once we beat Renala. And there's a great hammer that doesn't require too many stats that we can go get Lyria.
Well, that's kind of what I hope, to beat Renala first so that we can respec whenever we feel like we need to. Ow.
I'm so afraid to not be at full health.
That's fair. But probably in about two bosses, it won't matter.
Eventually you get that physique perk that just gives you a damage bubble.
That's true.
Makes a hit for you. I think if I keep chopping at his tail, I'll do okay.
It's just hard for him to keep aggro. It's not like Monster Hunter, you can't actually hit the tail.
I'm gonna cut it off, goddammit. Actually, in some Souls games you can. There are two or three bosses in Dark Souls where if you cut off their tails, you get a unique weapon from them.
Really?
Yeah.
That's cool.
It's the gnawing dragon. It's the big weird alligator dragon at the bottom of the sewers. And then the gargoyle, if you cut off his tail, you can get the gargoyle tail axe. Which is, like, a cool concept, but it sucks.
Ow. Rolled the wrong way.
I'm coming, buddy.
Oh, that's fine. These bites I can eat. That I can't. He's coming with the 360.
I got the bleed!
Nice.
Finally!
As you die?
No. I think he's one jump attack away.
Oh, he's one attack away, bud.